questions. I would try and stick to the time of 15 minutes. Basically, just to introduce, I lead the Converged business for Dell in India. And today we are going to talk more, I'll try to make it very simple, the technology piece that we are going to talk about so the audience here can relate to it. So before I start about what we do in Dell, I'll put a picture of a person over here. I don't know whether you know who this person is. Anyone aware of who the person is? It's not Mr. Dell, and neither it is me when I was young. The name of this person is Alan Turing. Anyone heard of Alan Turing before? Now, the reason why I've put his picture is there is actually a movie made on this guy, and it's called The Imitation Effect. And the reason why I've put his picture, I was saying, is because he was the person who created the first ever computer. So it was not called a computer then. It was way back in 1943 that a machine was created, and it was created for a purpose. The purpose of this machine was to decipher the codes. So Germany was at war at that point in time and with England, and they were sending some very, they were interacting using some codes. Now those codes had to be deciphered, so a machine was needed. So these guys went about creating that machine, and ultimately what came out was a machine which weighed some 18 tons. A lot of technology went into it, and a lot of stuff which was inside it costed a lot of money at that point in time. But people found that this is of value, right? And they started working to make it simple, because at the end of it, this was the machine which saved their lives of a lot of people. England was able to decipher the codes using this machine. But having said that, today, human nature, we don't want to keep something that useful, which takes so much of time to build and to manage and to take it around, so we made it simpler. So the technology which was there in that big machine, three times more technology is there in actually in our own pockets right now. So that is how technology has advanced over the years. And had this machine been there at that point in time, probably the war would have never happened. But having said that, this is the magic of technology. And today, when you look at a similar concept in today's scenario, it's not a Turing machine, but it looks somewhat like that. Anyone able to gauge what this is? This room? Pardon me? I heard someone saying data center. No. So basically, it is a data center. It is called a data center. It is not the data center of some of our customers, but it has a lot of technology in it, just like that Turing machine was. It has servers, it has storage, as you can see, a lot of cables. But that machine was there to save lives. If someone goes in this, I don't know whether they'll come out alive. Having said that, we have simplified even a data center. And today, Dell EMC has a solution in which the data center looks like this. So this is nothing but a data center. It has compute, it has a network, it has storage, it has softwares, it has backup, it has replication. So for the audience which are not too technical, this is where all your applications run. So today, when you're ordering an Uber, or actually going to internet banking, it hits this. And that is where the technology happens, the magic happens, and you're able to communicate so fast on your mobile or your laptop or any other devices. But having said that, this infrastructure is not what we buy today just because we like buying infrastructure, right? Today, let's say if there is a sale down the street and Reebok and Adidas have, let's say, 75% off, we'll go running over there probably to get our hands on the best lot. But when I say today Dell is offering a 50% discount on its infrastructure, I don't know how many partners here will be excited. Oh, they might be thinking at the back of the mind that Dell to 80% discount deta hai. What is 50%? But we buy in infrastructure, why? Because the applications that want to, supposed to run on it. And today when we buy infrastructure, for the applications, we buy it in a very traditional manner. we buy layers of infrastructure. Layers include something like a network, which is managed by a software. We need people for that. This is where all the money that Wipros, the Infosys, and the Cognizance of the world make, when they supply people to manage IT infrastructure, to set it up. And most of us also make a lot of money over there. But having said that, there are other layers of infrastructure like storage, like servers, like software, virtualization, which are built to run this application per se. So tomorrow, if a bank decides that it wants to have an internet banking application, this is the process they will follow. They will buy all the layers. They'll buy probably a network from Cisco, a storage from Dell, servers from Intel, and some softwares from some vendor. Having said that, once they do this, they have to do a lot of interoperability tests, and only then they can run the infrastructure, the application on this infrastructure. Now, this consumes a lot of time and effort. A lot of money is wasted. But having said that, things changed. People want better innovation. So what happened was, in 2009, someone decided out there saying that, look, earlier we used to build our own PCs, buy a monitor from somewhere, CPU from somewhere, all the machines from there. But why don't we do the same with all these complex elements on the data center? So they built a stack together, and they called it Converged Infrastructure with a single management. So just consider it an equivalent of a laptop in the data center, a machine which can run all your workloads. And no problems on patching, on support, it's just a single call away or a single click away. And it helped the customers in many ways. It was faster, it was simpler, it was more robust. At the same time, it was more cheaper. Not just cheaper because it was cheaper, but because it was so lean that it consumed less resources in the data center. But this was because of the power of one. Organizations came together, they realized that there is a problem. Cisco, EMC, Intel, VMware came together and delivered this solution. But then what happened is, today in this today's world, you see, everything which is physical is becoming virtual. So there were physical cars, now it became an Ola, which is an app. So and then there is a physical hotel, but now it becomes an app. So you book the hotel, you book the car on a software. In the same way, these hardware elements became software. Software network, software storage, software compute, so on and so forth. So this entire world of hardware is now just a software, which means today if you have, let's say, 20 computers or 10 servers in your organization, put these softwares and it will convert the entire storage inside into a pool of storage, compute inside into a pool of compute and deliver the results. Which means tomorrow if you want to start a bank, an e-bank rather, all you need is 10 servers or 10 machines at your home. Put these softwares and you are ready to deploy applications and start running on it. But when you do that, make sure that you use the technologies which are latest. Some technologies which are latest are SSDs. Some technologies which are latest is buy what you need today, grow tomorrow. Something which is latest is something which can run between here or Amazon or Azure kind of clouds. But at the end of the day, what is important is the data. So today when you are setting up an infrastructure, you have my data, you have the data of other people out here, and they are trusting you with the data. Make sure that that data is retained for your customers and make sure that you have educate backups or replication in place. So you have two options. If you are tech savvy, customers are tech savvy, go ahead and buy a la carte components, as I mentioned before, to run your applications, or simply order a system and it will be delivered to your doorstep. All you have to do, put the softwares you want to on top of it. And today Dell EMC has three product categories that you can avail of to deliver this experience. And just to let you know, even the laptops and desktops that you are using today can be virtualized. And users don't have to pay the kind of heavy money they are paying today to buy a laptop or a desktop. You can have a virtual desktop, and that works because this works at the back end, and a tablet or a screen will be connected to the user, which will get connected at the back end. We are doing a project at the State Bank of India where all their branches will not have a single desktop or a laptop. They will have just a monitor. The monitor will connect backend to a server, which is one of these kind, and that server will deliver the resources which a laptop or a desktop delivers. So this is what the solutions are with Dell EMC. You can choose either of the three solutions depending on your use case. We can work with your partners, customers, we can work with your team to make them understand what these technologies are, and we can work to design a solution for the customers. Maybe the customer is not as big as the State Bank of India, but even if it's a small customer, the same value can be delivered across. Which means today, if he has an idea, to make that idea functional, all you need is just, so this is a busy slide, but just to let you know, a desktop today for a user in a corporate that you are working for, along with all the capabilities that we just spoke of, can be delivered at $11 per user per month. Which means, just imagine the kind of saving, and this is all Dell hardware, which means we'll give you a monitor, a product called Thin Client. I don't know, we have Thin Clients on display over here. So we'll show what the Thin Client is, in case you want to see. It's not a bulky thing like a laptop, it's a very lean thing. It fits behind the monitor. And this is what you get, and this is what comes at the user side. At the other side, it connects to the servers at the back end. So just imagine the cost per user is as low as $11. And if you go and talk to customers about this, and they'll be more than happy. Today, if they are buying Dell machines, which are costing 50, 60, 70,000 or whatever the range is, giving them an offer of $11 with all the capabilities and better performance than what a laptop or a desktop delivers is something which is very much more exciting. We have seen users adopting this in a very big way. But having said that, not all the users have reached the maturity to understand the value of technology. Many users are there. Are there in the journey of this. But traditionally, customers have been using this kind of technology. They are sticking to this kind of technology. Having said that, we are all in the process of transformation. And there are customers who are looking at this solution in form of a hybrid environment. Do talk to Dell EMC because we are number one in providing these solutions. You talk of servers, compute, storage, converged, hyper-converged. There is one company who has been number one, continues to be number one. You talk of any report which Gartner releases or IDC releases, you will see that there have been number one. There have been multiple customers globally and in India who have deployed these solutions, which means they are mature enough. And we can talk about these solutions to some of our customers that we know of. And we'll welcome you to contact our representatives in Dell EMC and work with us to avail of the exciting offer we just showed off. And some of the devices which I just spoke of are also outside. Just check them out in case you wish. So that's all from my side. Thank you very much for being a patient audience. Hope I wasn't too technical.